followed by number 4, Zoe Bauer. Number 12, Drew Moore. Number 23, Clayton Webb. And rounded out the starting lineup for your Holy Cross Saints, number 24, Carl Columbus. Now, Great Lakes Christian College, stand on your feet and let's meet your Crusader starters. Starting with number 3, he's from Detroit, DeJuan Williams. Number 10, he's from Pontiac, his name is Dana Thomas. Followed by, he hails from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, number 25, Tommy Bentley. Next on your starting lineup is number 30. His name is David Parks. And rounded out the starting lineup, he hails from Detroit. His name is Jalen James. Shot made by number 23. Assist to number 12.
Made.
Three-point miss by number 25, Tommy Bitten. Three-pointer made by number 4, Zoe Bauer.
File on Maroon 23. His first team vote.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Doty Center, home of Great Lakes Christian College. We apologize for the late start of the broadcast. Great Lakes Christian College taking on Holy Cross Notre Dame tonight. Great Lakes coming to this one 0-14. Holy Cross are 1-1. Holy Cross, the clear favorite tonight. They take it down to the other end. They can't finish. They currently lead at 5-0, 18 minutes to go here in the first. I'm Colton Wesley. I'm here with my partner, Julio Wilbanks. We're really excited to bring you this one. David Parks in the high post, loses the ball, hits the turf, coming the other way now. Holy Cross.
It looks like David got caught in the knee and didn't call that with a foul. But
shot made by number 4, Zoe Bauer.
Great Lakes is calling a timeout.
30-second timeout by your Crusade.
That did not take long at all. So thank you once again for joining us. We apologize for the late start. Great Lakes Christian College, the host tonight.
As we start off with 1743-7-0, Great Lakes behind.
Off to a rough start, Great Lakes in this one. What are the Lakes going to have to do in order to get back, get into this one right from the get-go, get involved, have a chance to win this game?
It's a hard one to tell right now. Everyone's, they seem to be playing equally. There's no disadvantage. There's no height disadvantage. There's no... It's just really... I've never seen these guys before, but from our past history, we do recognize the fact that, you know, we've lost to them last year, previously years. But they've, you know, from what I've heard from the coaches, they can't be beaten. They're not that fantastic.
As we start off with Holy Cross playing the same conference as teams such as Purdue North Central. Teams Great Lakes have played before. Tommy Bentley gives this one up to Jalen James. James, Dana Thomas in the high post. Back out to Dwan Williams, and they'll reset. Dwan going to try to drive, kicks it out to Jalen. This is something Great Lakes have tried to do, work the ball around the perimeter. NBA three, no good. Rebound underneath Dwan Williams, just able to save it. No, it touched the line. And
shot missed
out.
By David Park.
Ball turned over to Holy Cross.
Great Lakes almost wanted to press, but not everyone was participating in that press.
This is Carl Columbus on the ball. Feeds it underneath Clayton Webb. Backs down, puts it up, gets it partially blocked by Bentley.
Shot missed
rebound,
by 23. Rebounded by number three, DeWan Williams.
Williams, Parks, James in the corner for three. No good off the front rim. Strong rebound from O'Brien Hobbs, a 5'9 guard. Working on Dana Thomas. Hobbs plays it underneath. Nice up and underneath from Columbus. No good.
24
rebound,
minutes.
David
number
Parks
30, David
way.
Parks with
Thomas.
The rebound.
This is Bentley, pulls up, long two, no good, in and out. Rebound coming the other way, Clayton
shot
Webb.
Missed by
back out to Drew
Bentley.
Moore.
Rebounded by number 23.
We're getting a lot of opportunities to make almost three opportunities, but right now we're all in a rush.
This game has picked a bit, neither team finishing on the offensive end to Dwan. The Lakes working around the perimeter. This is to do all year. They've had varying levels of success with this. Jalen tries to drive, gives it up. Dana for three, missed that one badly off the front rim. Coming the other way, Clayton Webb.
Three missed by Dana, rebounded by number 23.
Three, good rebound, Columbus underneath, and we have a whistle.
We
so
got a foul on your Great Lakes Christian.
Seven, still unable to score.
On number 30, David Parks,
and we have
team
first.
For
the first. Halton will check into the game. Nope, it's two shot foul, so they'll have to wait till until the first shot is gone. Amazing after a foul.
Right.
First free throw from Columbus is good. Now
free
Sam
made
Anderson
by number
and Sean Kolmachek back into the game. Sam Anderson, he's been one of the team's more efficient players when he's had minutes.
Yeah, he's very, you know, he stands his ground. He lets the big boys come after him, and that's a great advantage in Great Lakes.
Sean Colton.
And 24
he's
makes
done
them
quite
both.
A bit of good. Shot about 50% inside the arc this year. Columbus knocks down both free throws, and now coming the other way, Great Lakes ball down 9-0. That one's knocked up into the air, picked up by Anderson. Nice dish from Anderson to Williams, takes it rack to rack. Couldn't finish. That was a nice play by Anderson to save it, but they couldn't turn it into points. So Brian Hobbs drives, lays it up. It's good.
Shot
that's
made by number one, O'Brien Hobbs.
For the Saints.
11-0. Great Lakes still behind.
Great Lakes not usually a team that struggle to find points. But tonight they've not been able to shoot at all. David pulls up for a three. No good front rim. Great Lakes
three
forcing their
David
shots.
Rebound,
much like they did
four.
A couple of nights ago when they took on Purdue Calumet.
This is the biggest struggle that we have when it comes to our shooters. We want to just throw our shots, try to make points in there, but
that was a nice drive by Zoe Bauer.
By
he just drove
four,
right to
Zoe
the rack
Bauer.
And finished it. 13-0 the score now. Dwan Williams gives it up to David Parks. Colton open three in the corner. No good. Rebound all the way out. Dwan Williams knocks it out of bounds. Great Lakes off to a really rough start shooting the ball, taking so many threes.
So many threes, inaccurate threes, and they're such fast pace that kind of ridiculous. We're throwing shots that are almost have no potential of going in at all whatsoever.
Well, here's the thing. When you're only shooting 27% as a team from beyond the arc, you've got to work the ball around, got to try to find some better shots. They've just not done that. This is Drew Moore. Into the corner. Adam Vizard inside. Stolen by Tommy Bentley. Up to Jalen. Jalen across to Sean
Shot
Colton.
Shot made by number 22, Sean Colton. Assist from Jalen James.
That's a nice play right there. Finally,
beautiful
Great
play
get
and
a
made
transition
a decision.
Basket.
You know, whether or not he wanted to make that shot or not, he made Rice choice passing that ball.
Darryl McIntyre getting worked on by Colton there. Great Lakes defending now. Doing a much better job keeping that ball at the perimeter. That ball's inside now to Hobbs. Goes up, no good. Rebound underneath by Michael Anderson. He gets rejected. Back out to Vi Moore. Drew Moore. Oh, he looked like he might have walked there, but he didn't. Coming the other way now. Hobbs kicks it out. Moore, open look. Knocks it
three
down.
Three made by number 12, Drew Moore.
16
assist,
two,
number
Great
one,
Lakes
O'Brien
behind.
Hobbs.
Jalen running the point now, and he's calling something out.
Although we did try to have some aggressive defense, they timed that clock very wisely.
Bentley almost lost that. Gives it up to Colton, and they'll reset it. 16 to shoot now. Inside Colton. Nice catch and shoot from the free throw line, but no good. That's his shot right there. He's hit a lot of those this year.
He's a pass and shoot kind of guy, and that's a very one rare shot we rarely see miss.
Again, he shoots about 50% inside the arc. Nice defensive play there by Sam Anderson knocking the ball out.
Sam Anderson playing some good defense, taps the ball out, but ends up getting out of bounds.
David Parks will check out. All kinds of substitutions being made right now. And now Williams will check in. So Jalen James, Sam Anderson, Sean Colton, Dwan Williams, Dana Thomas on the floor for Great Lakes. 13-11 to go here in the first. Great Lakes in a 6.
12, Drew Moore, assist, number one, O'Brien High.
And now, it looks like they're
there has to be
up
some water on the court.
Yep.
There's
some moisture in front of the Great Lakes bench.
A delay on playing time.
Now we have the inbound. That one's underneath, and we have
a kickball violation by Great Lakes.
That ball got kicked on the inbound. Inbound once again from the baseline. All the way out. Now they work it down inside, and we have another whistle.
We were following your Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders. Number 42,
and they're
going to
get Sam
Anderson.
Anderson, and this is really something that he
his
struggled
first
with.
Team second.
He's, picked up, he's picked up his his picked up his fair share of fouls when in the middle. This is something he's going to have to work on. Into the corner now, working it back around. This is Darryl McIntyre inside. Carl Columbus kicks it back out for Bauer. Columbus, who dropped
shot made by number 24.
That lead. It's now 18-2. Williams. The point gives it up to Jalen. Back out to Dwan. Back out to Jalen. Jalen tries to drive. Kick out. Open look by Sean Colton for three. Knocks
and
it.
3-point
nice
basket made
three
by number 22. Sean Colton. 44. Jalen.
5.
Not exactly his shot. He doesn't shoot. When you're that wide open, you got to knock those down, right? Zoe Bauer on the Sean Colton tries to find Dana Thomas deep, but Thomas didn't get his head around. Bauer gives it up to Columbus, and now the Saints will set it up. This is Vizard. Michael Ogner-Pedersen inside. This is Bauer. Can't get it to playing for it underneath. The board and the putback no good from
and
but
one.
It is good from Bauer.
Offensive rebound by number 33, Mike Ogner. Pullback and a foul. Foul on number 42, Sam Anderson. His second, team third.
And it's already two on Sam Anderson. So now David Parks will check in replacing Anderson. Dana Thomas will check out. Nathan Shelton will enter.
Nice.
you notice there's nobody on the rebound shots.
What does that tell you about Michael Ogner-Pedersen's free throw shooting? It's probably going to knock it down. If no one's there to pick up the rebound, it means there's probably not going to be one coming the other way, Duane.
It's kind of an insult in a way, secretly.
Jalen James. He's going to run the point, 18 to shoot here. Still holding the ball, gives it up to Nathan Shelton. Inside, Duane pulls up mid-range jumper, knocks it
shot
down.
Shot made
by
number
look,
three,
but he got it to
Duane Williams.
Better job of creating opportunities, because that kind of shot is not sustainable. This is McIntyre, and he walked.
And Great Lakes ball.
Nope, correction, it's a foul away from the ball.
We have an illegal screen by number
23
of Holy Cross, his
senior from Dallas.
Team second.
And make an offensive position to play.
This is Duane Williams now. Still working around that perimeter. Sean puts up a three, and he airballed it.
I think the defensive player got a tip out of that.
Again, that's not really his shot. He shot only 17% or so coming in from beyond the arc. They work it underneath,
number 33,
and that's
Mike Ogner.
It's a well play.
23-7, 10.5 to go here in the first. Great Lakes going to have to find some way to stop the bleeding. Down by 16 here in the first. Park. Down low. Williams going to try to drive. We have a whistle. Carl Columbus didn't set his feet.
We'll follow number 24, Red. His first.
And now Dalton Wagler will check into the game for the Saints. Colton will inbound from the baseline. Shelton tried to catch and shoot. That instead he tries to drive.
Shot
puts up a low percentage look
Nathan
underneath.
Shelton.
And now coming the other way, Ogner-Pedersen.
Defensively, Great Lakes is trying to find a way to keep up.
Into the corner for three.
Made
Zoe
by
Bauer
four.
Knocks it down.
Zoe Bauer assists to number
another
24.
Another transition basket
Columbus.
For Holy Cross.
26-7. Great Lakes trailing behind deeply.
Back to Williams. Williams tries to drive the baseline, puts it up, doesn't get the fall, but he does get the foul. I think that's going to be the second on Columbus.
Foul on number 24 of Holy Cross. His second, team fourth. Shooting two at the line for your Crusaders. Number three, Duane Williams.
So now Duane will go to the line to shoot a pair. Knocks down the first. Duane about a 71% free throw shooter. Checking into the game now is Drew Moore.
He shoots and makes it in.
So that's good. Duane Williams knocks them both down, and it's 26-9. Under 10 to go here in the first. Moore over the timeline. Gives
really
it up to
trying
Ogner-Pedersen.
To do a press.
McIntyre working around the perimeter. This is Drew Moore. Moore tries to drive. Jalen shuts the door, kicks it back out. Around the perimeter again into Zoe Bauer. Drew Moore puts up a three. 3-point
basket
knocks
made
it
by
down.
Number 12.
Drew
Moore.
Got to find a way to
Moore.
Shut that down on the perimeter. It's a 20-point game now.
Yeah, that's a scary game. We only have 9 minutes left of the game.
James hands this one off to Duane. Duane made his man miss, but then he looked up and got away from the plate. Parks. Pumps, tries to drive, gives it up to Jalen. Into the corner now, it's Colton. Back to Parks in the high post. Well defended by Wagler, giving up to Colton in the low
shot
post.
Shot made by number 22.
There's
John
an easy, nice
Putton.
Pass,
assist
jump
to
shot,
number 30.
And he made it in
David
like he normally
Putton.
Does.
Not the easiest look in the world, but he knocks it down. 29-11, 8 3/4 to go here in the first. Daryl McIntyre, top of the key. Gives it up to Moore, who drives all the way back into the other corner. Ogner-Pedersen drives, puts it up, gets it to fall and one on
basket
David Parks.
Made by number 33.
And now Jeremy Lee will check
with
in.
With the foul on the basket. On number 30.
Second on Parks.
His second.
And it is.
Team four.
So now Jeremy Lee will check in, replacing Duane Williams.
David has two fouls, and Sam Anderson has two fouls.
Jeremy Lee's been a pretty solid player for this team. So maybe he can add something. Ogner Pettersson knocks down the free throw, and it's 32-11.
Drillick slowly crossing the line.
This is Jalen running the point. Lee, more of a defender than an attacker, gives it up to Shelton. Now it's Jalen. Calton again. Parks working that perimeter still. Parks tries to step in, feeds to Calton underneath. Back out to Parks, pulls up three high posts, no good. Off the front rim, coming the other way is Bauer on the board.
He's almost a little too far. His shots are normally accurate. That tells me he's hitting that rim almost.
Great Lakes not taking the highest percentage looks.
Basket missed by number four, Zoe Bauer. Rebound
by David
Parks. Got to
work the ball and got to create better opportunities. That shot no good from Bauer. Rebound Parks. Jalen just going to try to drive and lay it in. And that's the default setting for a lot of these guys. They just try to drive when things aren't going well. Coming the other way, the layup.
Layup by number
12. Drew Moore is good,
Drew
and John Piercefield's seen enough.
Full timeout called by your Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders.
This has not exactly been a dream first half for Great Lakes. They trail 34-11.
At all.
7:33 to go, or 7:36 to go, rather, in the first.
You know, right now, from what it seems like, it's all about discipline. Who is more disciplined? Who is more organized? And Great Lakes is slowly catching up. But oh my goodness, we're not there yet completely. But we'll get there, maybe. Second half, you know, we always turn around our second half. Last game, what is it? Tuesday last week, we were playing a hard team, and we turned around. Our second half was better than our first half. That was the phenomenal thing for us. Maybe that's what's going to happen for us this coming tonight. We can turn everything around, make our baskets in. You know, our biggest problem is our first half, our buckets will not go in. I don't know what it is. Are we not warmed up? Are we not wanting to work it in? Or are we just too much in a rush? It's hard to tell.
You make a good point. Great Lakes, they've not been a first half team, to say the least. Lakes yet to go into halftime with a lead this season to Jalen James. Calton will bring it up over the timeline. 28 to shoot, 7:27 left in the first. This is Jalen. Tries to drive. Gives us up to Jeremy Lee. Lee is doubled now. Almost lost it. Picks it up. Almost lost it again. And then he throws it away, but somehow manages to get back on it, and we have a foul.
Sometimes when you charge for a ball that you can get ineffective due to the fact that the last person who had the ball, and then you have the defensive trying to charge
team
for the ball
fifth.
Instead of the player, sometimes it can be very dangerous, which can cause you a foul.
Drew Moore getting credit for the foul there. So somehow the Lakes avoid the turnover. Now this is Parks. Inside, Lee goes to the rack, lays it up, no good. Lakes can't get a roll for anything right now. Zoe Bauer on the board gives it up to O'Brien Hobbs. Into the corner, McIntyre. Outside to Moore. This is Wagler. Underneath to McIntyre, backs down, puts it up. Doesn't get it to fall, but he's fouled underneath by Sean Calton.
Foul on number 22, Sean Calton. His first, team fifth.
It feels like every time Great Lakes are fouled, Holy Cross, they've gone to the line. But if there is a silver lining to be taken away right now, Great Lakes have only fouled five times.
Yeah.
Historically, Great Lakes have been in the bonus quite a bit at this stage of the first half.
Checking into the game for your Crusaders.
Bentley and Williams
DeJuan
will check
Williams
in,
and Tommy
Shelton
Bentley.
And Lee. Six and 45 to go. Free throw is good.
It's good.
So Holy Cross go 1-for-2 from the line. Dwan Williams brings it up over the timeline.
35-11 with 6.5 minutes to go.
Jalen gives it up to Bentley. Dwan Williams now across to David Parks. Puts up a three. No good off the front rim. Rebound coming the other way. Zoe Bauer. Great Lakes have been shorting a lot of these threes today. McIntyre, kick out. Moore gives this one up to Bauer. Working around the perimeter once again. Inside, Wagler tries to get position on Parks
basket
and lays it in.
By number 30. Assist to number
37-11, 6:08 to go here in the first. Colton breaks the press, drives all the way in. And that's going to get knocked out by O'Brien Hobbs.
Good defense on cross. Lakes offensively was not fully aware of what was going on the press.
Calls. Tommy Bentley. Colton tries to drive. He kicks it back to Jalen James. 15 to shoot. James to Williams. Holy Cross not giving an inch. Williams able to get
basket
some space on the baseline.
DeJuan
Williams lays it in. That's what he's been doing all year, creating baskets with his pace. Now coming the other way, we have a whistle. No basket, foul on Williams.
Foul on number 3, DeJuan Williams.
Williams has been one of the team's so far this year. Leads the team in steals.
Holy Cross makes the substitutes. Number 11 is now on board.
Coley Schultheis checks in there. A little in and out. O'Brien Hobbs underneath. Wagler pressured, gives it away.
Steal by number 3, DeJuan Williams.
Williams feeds it into Jalen, who can't hold on. And it's coming the other way.
Turnover, Crusaders.
37-13, 5:23 to go here in the first. Inbound O'Brien Hobbs. Gives it up to McIntyre. This is Bauer. Schultheis. Still working around the perimeter. This is inside, knocked away from Hobbs, but he picks it up and lays
basket
it in.
Basket by number 1,
wow.
O'Brien Hobbs.
39-13.
Lake's getting tripled right now. Dwan, Jalen. This is Tommy Bentley all the way across to Williams. Takes a step back, tries to drive, kicks it out. Parks open, look for 3. No good. He's been unlucky from downtown tonight. Rebound Colton, can't get the put back. The Lakes have not been an offensive rebounding team. When you get those opportunities, you really need to put them back.
And it's a charge.
By number 4 of Holy
David Crown. Finally says, thank you, referee.
Bauer loses the ball over the end line. It'll be Great Lakes ball. Sean Colton will inbound. So checking in on the floor for Great Lakes, Tommy Bentley, David Parks, Jalen James, Sean Colton, and now DeJuan Williams, who is in possession, gives it up to Jalen. Working around the perimeter, tries to drive, kick out. Dwan going to put up a 3 and knocks
and
it down.
3-point basket made by number 3.
Our first
DeJuan
3
Williams
goes in.
Assist.
Dwan,
Jalen
not
James.
The best 3-point shooters. He's 4-for-18 on the season, but he knocked that one down with authority. And it's 13.
Losing by 20 points, which is slowly catching up there.
Bauer now works it back inside to Anderson. All the way back out. Driving a lane is Daryl McIntyre. The shot's no good, but the rebound for Columbus. Kicked out to Bauer, and the Saints will reset. Under 4 to go in the first. Bauer pulls up for 3, no good. Rebound David Parks. Long ball forward to Colton. Lake's trying to run the floor. Colton tries to feed it into James, but it's picked off. Coming
the
other way
is Zoe
pass. Bauer.
It wasn't fast enough for that pass to happen. It was a smart move, but the pass was just not fast enough.
This is McIntyre inside. Anderson layup is good.
Basket made by number 43.
Anderson is a 6'6", 185
Mike
senior.
Anderson.
That's a mismatch underneath for just about anybody for Great Lakes. Great Lakes is a pretty small team at this point. Jalen jacks up an NBA 3 and just completely missed. Off of the brick, coming the other way, O'Brien Hobbs goes for the layup. No good. And we have a whistle. And we have a push off underneath. It'll be Great Lakes ball. They're going to get Anderson.
Foul on Red, 43. His first team 6.
The whole bench is kind of coming back in. Sam Anderson, Dana, can't think of his last name, number 10.
Sam Anderson, Dana Thomas, and Jeremy Thomas. Lee checking into the game. They will join Jalen and DeJuan Williams, and now Nathan Shelton will come to the scorer's table. He'll check in at the next stoppage. 3 minutes to go here in the first. Great Lakes down 41-16. This is Jeremy Lee. Dwan drives to drive, pulls up long two, no good. Rebound underneath goes to Dana Thomas, and we have a foul.
That's a smart shot for Dana Thomas.
Foul on number 43.
It's going to be Anderson again.
His second team. Foul line for your
and
Crusaders. Number
line.
10, Dana Thomas.
Two. He's only 8 for 15 from the line so far this year. He'd love to get both of these to fall. No good off the front rim, and now Nathan Shelton will check on Williams.
Nathan Shelton checking your Crusaders for number 44.
He's replacing James. Dwan Williams will remain in the game.
Gainer shoots and rolls right
second free throw is good.
So par for the
10,
course for Thomas
Dana
from the line.
Thomas.
Coming the other way now. Schultheis throws this one in to Anderson, who lays it in underneath.
Shot made by number 43, Mike
Sam
Anderson.
Sam Anderson couldn't do anything about
assist
that.
To number 11.
He hopped right over him, Kobe. And the guys, like, brushed him off.
Thomas, Shelton, Williams has loads of this line and walks
basket
it in.
Basket made by number
3,
DeJuan
beautiful
Williams.
Roll inside that ball.
That's really the first he's had a lot of room to work with, and he took full advantage. Bauer drives the lane, layup, he gets it to fall.
Basketball
there. Anderson inbounds to Dwan Williams. 2:10 to go here in the first. Great Lakes down 45-19. This is Thomas now. Gives it up to Anderson. Anderson gives this one up to Dwan Williams. Williams tries to drive. Contested look,
basketball,
but he gets
number
it to fall.
Three, Dwan Williams.
Dwan finds ways to create points out of nothing. We've seen him do it time and time again this season. Coley Schultheis. Drew Moore. This is Schultheis again. Underneath to Anderson. Back to Schultheis. He drives. Goes for the layup. He gets blocked away by Dwan. Season. Williams will bring it up the other way. Williams going to go coast to coast.
Shot
and lay it in.
Put number 3.
Great individual.
Williams.
Dwan Williams. That's his second block of the year.
Coast.
Grabs the board and just takes it all the way.
That's
it's
3 points. Back to back to back. For Dwan.
Drew Moore. Out to Zoe Bauer. This is Moore again in the high post. Tries to drive, kicks it out to Bauer. Now into the corner. Still working around the perimeter. Visored on the ball now. Green goes in. Last no good. And we have a walk. So less than a minute to go here in the first. Great Lakes down 45-23.
Turnover by Holy Cross, number 43.
Can we make it so we're only losing by 20 points by the end of the half? I believe so.
Well, here's a good opportunity
checking
to go
2-for-1. Checking into the
for
game
one.
For your Crusaders, Sean Colton.
The inbound to Sean Colton.
Use the time wisely.
Gives it up to Jeremy Lee. Lee working on the defender, kicks it back out. This is Thomas. Back out to Sean. This is Lee. Colton in the corner underneath to Nathan Shelton, who was open but couldn't hold on to the ball. Tries to throw back in. It's turned over. Anderson picks it up. Coming the other way. The shot clock's dead. Under 30 to shoot. Puts it up. No good. Rebound underneath, and we have a whistle. Ball went out over the baseline. Rebound to Adam Visard. He will inbound. McIntyre will check in. Joey Bauer.
5-23 doing that bad. We've gained. Oh.
Inbound to McIntyre. This is Schultheis. Now it's Moore. Holy Cross will likely hold for the last shot here. Moore. 12 to shoot. Kicks it out to Schultheis. Still working around the perimeter. This is Moore. 6. No good. Rebound underneath, ball bouncing around, 3 to shoot, out of bounds. It would be Great Lakes ball with 2:3 to go in the half.
3-point basket missed by number 12.
Lee will inbound from the
Crusaders
baseline.
Crusaders basket.
Into Thomas, and Thomas just, I don't know what that was. I have no idea what happened there. Somebody wasn't looking at the clock, and that runs out the half. So we reach halftime here at the Doty Center.
The
Great Lakes in a hole here. 45
and your Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders.
This is the Great Lakes Christian College Television Network. Hello, everyone, and welcome back for the second half. Great Lakes Christian College trailing 45-23 to Holy Cross Notre Dame at the break.
Great Lakes has the ball. Passes around the perimeter.
Dana Thomas pulls up for three from the corner. No good off the front rim. Rebound to Drew Moore. They're coming the other way.
Dana Thomas.
So what do you think that John Piercefield said to his guys at halftime?
Use that time wisely. I think that's the biggest thing right now. Way too much in a rush right now.
We need to find a way
to slow down that pace.
His third.
I think the biggest key at this point is patience, because these guys aren't good tonight. They're really not. They're really not that of a disadvantage to play with these guys.
You're saying that
basket made by number 44, Jalen James,
is not as great as the difference has been between us and previous opponents.
Most definitely, these guys are just really in a rush, and that's what's making us be in a rush is their pace. If we can teach ourselves as players, our own team to not be like that, it's perfectly fine.
So Jalen James knocks in a bucket for Great Lakes on one, and on the other end we have a foul. I think that's going to be on David Parks. That'd be his third.
Foul on number 44.
No, correct, that's on Jalen
James. His first.
And that will
first
be his
of the
first.
First free throw miss.
And he misses his first shot. And no good.
No good off the front rim.
Rebound
coming
10.
The other way ahead to Dwan Williams, but he couldn't corral it, and it goes out.
We were in a hurry, trying to get a fast break. No reason. Defensive, they were already there.
Zoe Bauer will inbound. This is O'Brien Hobbs. Moore. Underneath to Webb.
Basket made by number 24.
Into a running Columbus,
assist,
and he lays
number 23.
It in. Nice run into the lane by Columbus. Nothing was going to stop him there, and it's a 22-point game. Williams was thinking about driving there. Kicks it back out to Jalen. Bentley pulls up for three. Knocks it down.
Three-point basket made by number 25, Tommy Bentley.
A nice, smooth three. Here's going to be the difference in our play offensively is that, wow.
Three-point basket made
Quick
by number 12.
Moore buries the three. You were saying?
The biggest thing is that they're going to change defensively on the other team is that they, and Tommy makes a two-point shot. They're now concentrating on going to be
basket
on
made by number 25, Tommy.
Mr. Bill. Williams. Mr. Williams is such an effective going inside the box. They're going to try and prevent him from doing that. They're going to try and make him shoot outside.
Moore
steal
loses
by number
the
ball.
Three. To Jalen goes behind the back. The layup. No good contact to lay it in. Turnaround, Columbus going to drive on Thomas and a foul on David
Parks. Gets a foul on him.
Foul
no.
on number 10, Dana Thomas.
Dana.
His third, team second.
That will be the first
His
on
first.
Dana.
Sorry, correction.
Jalen James will check out. Sean Colton will check in. First free throw is no good from Columbus.
No,
checking
Dana's been down
today,
a bunch,
Thomas, number 22, Sean Colton.
Jalen's still on board.
Okay, then.
And for Holy Cross, number 32,
so James
Colton, Mike
Parks,
Owen.
Williams, Bentley. Second free throw from Columbus is good.
Second free throw by number 22.
Holy Cross have not really been, they've not had players on the key. Second free throw much all evening. Not sure if that's a trend or if they really believe in their free throw shooters. Jalen tries to drive, turnaround, no good.
Tommy gets
rebound,
the rebound,
Bentley underneath, and the
putback
is
by Jalen James. Rebounded
right
by
there,
number 25,
the
Tommy
score,
Bentley.
And then finishing the chance to
yeah,
score.
I agree. Getting that rebound back.
Hobbs, good pass inside to Webb. Webb backs down, lays it up, no good. The putback from Columbus is good. You just can't defend that.
He's a pretty big dude. He's got some hops on him.
Offensive rebound and putback by number 24.
Back to Dwan Williams. Bentley thought about pulling that up. Inside, Colton, turn around, no good. The catch
just
and shoot
a little short.
Colton's shot has not been there so far tonight. Coming the other way now is O'Brien Hobbs. Hobbs drives, pulls up, layup, it's good.
Shot made by number one, O'Brien
Coming
Hobbs.
The other way, Dwan Williams. Lakes down 53-32. Jalen. This is Williams. Bentley pulls up for three. No good off the front rim. Strong rebound. Hobbs coming the other way. Layup. No good. Rebound Webb is good.
We're not stopping the people getting inside of our box. We're just easily going for that shot and trying to aim for the go for the ball.
Timeout called by your Crusaders.
By John.
30-second timeout.
Our defense is not as aggressive as it was this first half. Our offense, we're shooting more accurate. We're using more time.
So it's 16-10 to go in the second. 155-32. So if Great Lakes is going to get back into this one, they're going to have to make a run very, very quickly. They fell behind immediately in this game. I just never got back.
And there was nothing we can do to catch stop that. Their baskets were going in, and our baskets weren't.
Shot selection's been an issue for Great Lakes much of the season. That's one of the reasons that they're only shooting about 36% from the floor coming into this game. Only two players on the roster shooting above 40% so far. Williams to Calton. Back to Parks. Pulls up long three. No good front rim. He's just not shot well tonight.
He's
coming
not
the other way.
All very well.
Hobbs going to drive and a foul on. No.
Traveling. Violation called on number one, O'Brien Hobbs.
I think I wasn't the only one who maybe saw the foul on James. Hobbs wanted the call too, but he didn't get it. Instead, it's going to be a walk. 15 and 52 to go here in the second. Great Lakes trailing 55-32. This is Dwan Williams. Tries to drive, and we have a whistle.
Number one, O'Brien Hobbs. His first team second.
They're going to get this one on Hobbs. It's first. Calton will inbound. Into the corner, Dwan Williams. Back to Jalen. Jalen tries to drive. Back out to Parks in the high post. Parks picks up the screen, gives it up to Dwan Williams. Williams going to drive. Loses his footing, throws it up off the backboard, looking for a foul, didn't get one. Coming the other way, Webb on the board. Ahead to Columbus, lays it
basket
in.
Basket made by number 24.
Good transition from Holy
Columbus.
Cross. They lead it by 25. Again, shot selection, an issue for Great Lakes right now.
Oh, man, this is a hard game to pick up on.
Parks pulls up, long two, no good. Strong rebound by Calton. That's an easy one to call on Drew Moore. He just went over the back. Drew
he
Moore,
tried
the 5'9".
He smack the ball off the hand, ends up smacking the arm.
Foul on number 12,
Drew Moore.
You can hear that smack all the way from here.
The second team
Drew
third.
Moore, the 5'9 guard from Dayton. Sean Colton's got a couple of inches on him, which it's not something that's easy. It's not something you can say very often for Great Lakes,
no.
To be honest. 15 to go here in the second. Great Lakes down 57-32. Some kind of hesitation on the inbound.
Referees are having some personal issues.
Colton will inbound. Anderson in the corner. He's playing with two fouls, pulls up, low post, that's a tough jumper, and he completely missed it. Coming the other way as Columbus gets right past Calton, gets past everyone, goes for the layup, no good. Rebound by Parks, it's tipped back out. Webb picks it up, and he's fouled on the way up.
And David gets a foul.
That's going to be on Sam, that's his third.
Foul on number 42, Sam Anderson, team third.
There's one thing that Sam Anderson has struggled with this season. It's giving away fouls.
First free throws missed by number 23.
You know what? As a beginner of playing basketball that you're not really sure of, you make a lot of mistakes. And Sam Anderson, his first year, he's just getting to know the game. He doesn't know the college-level basketball, so it's a whole new environment for him. So for him to be able to get up here and try to play is phenomenal.
Jalen Parks and Williams check out. The free throw is no good.
The rebound bounds all the way back out to Drew Moore, who picks it up, tries to drive, and a whistle on Danny Gleegard, who just checked in. On the floor now for Great Lakes, Gleegard, Lee, Colton, Anderson, and Bentley. This is an opportunity, at least John Christian sees it as an opportunity for Nethy. His bench driving the lane is Hobbs on the inbound. Danny Gleegard tried to take a charge, and he was unsuccessful.
Man, and both players got hit. How is that not a charge?
I mean, there was definitely contact there, but it was legal. There was nothing wrong with it. Colton coming the other way. Now Lake's down 27. Colton gives it up to Lee. Lee, Bentley, tries to drive, kicks it out to Anderson. Anderson thought of pulling it up. Gleegard pulls up for a three, and banks it in. The bank is open.
Danny Gleegard.
Okay, whatever. Hobbs brings it up the other way. Gives it up to Moore. Into the corner. Columbus down to Webb. Webb turns around and lays it in on Bentley. Colton coming the other way. Colton backs it out. Anderson. Bentley, top of the key. Throws this one down to Colton, who somehow holds it in, gets away from the guys, and drops the long two. Nice bucket from Colton. That was a pretty one, and the Lakes are down 61-37. 13 and a half to go here in the second. This is Moore. Moore goes in, and we have another whistle on Gleegard. He didn't establish himself. That's two on him. One of those guys who's learning the game.
His second.
He's aggressive for just getting inside, touching that game.
Soccer player by trade. And, I mean, he's a good athlete, but this is just a different game. What are you going to do, you know?
Yep.
Hobbs goes right into Gleegard, and now somehow, I don't know what
happened
there.
Turnover number one.
It wasn't a foul. I think Hobbs just lost the ball. Hobbs claiming that Gleegard didn't establish himself. Inbound to Lee. I don't know what to make of that one, to be honest.
That's
Anderson.
An interesting look.
It was a weird one. I haven't seen a play like that one yet this season. Colton, Bentley, top of the key. Colton shoots three, nails it.
Basket, good by number 22.
Colton
did
a couple of those
Colton.
From outside tonight.
He made
61
last time, and now he made another one
Tommy
here.
Bentley.
Again, as always, the second half, Great Lakes finds a way to make those baskets
basket
in.
Made.
Got to do better on the defensive end, though. McIntyre just went to the rack and laid it in. Colton brings it up. Bentley, Lee, crashes in, gets the roll,
basket
and one.
Basket made by number 11. Count the basket and a foul.
All of a sudden, Great Lakes decided to score some points.
Again, this is what Great Lakes is known for. Every game
24.
That we've gone to, first half, we're not making our baskets. We're not
his
falling.
Third.
Second half, whatever
Team
coach tells them, they listen, or they pick up together and they say, hey, you know what, let's figure something out here. The scary part is that this is not the starting five.
Lee's free throw is no good. Rebound Clayton Webb. Now this is Columbus. Into the corner. McIntyre. Back up to Hobbs. Columbus. Webb again, and we have a whistle away from the ball. A foul. They're going to get Daryl McIntyre.
Offensive foul on number 20. Drew McIntyre for hook.
And now Great Lakes down by 21 will inbound from the baseline.
Great Lakes is slowly picking up here.
Crowd's starting to get into it now. Bentley pulls up, turnaround three, nails it.
Basket, man, by 25.
All of a sudden, Great Lakes starting to bury some shots.
Great Lakes is slowly making their way up there.
Columbus brings it forward. Lakes down 18. This is Hobbs. Working around the perimeter. This is Webb. Driving the lane is Hobbs. Has to bring it back out, 15 to shoot, inside Columbus. Tries to drive, turnaround jumper, no good, back rim. The putback's no good, rebound underneath. Bounces around, we have a whistle, and it's out over the baseline.
42.
Follow
got
the
right
to
get Anderson. Okay, so they're gonna get Anderson for a whistle, that's his fourth. So, will someone explain to me what just happened? The reserves come in and all of a sudden just start lighting up some points. Like, what?
Where did that come from? This is exactly what I'm saying. We're making our points, and this isn't even our starting five. This is interesting. Great Lakes has a phenomenal, interesting flavor. Defense.
Basket made by number 24, Carl Columbus.
Columbus just got inside, and that's an easy one for him, to be honest. That's a great matchup for him on Jeremy Lee. Lee is really small. I mean, that's just not even fair, to be honest.
I mean,
what are you going
to
do?
Referees, they have to be careful how when they blow their whistle, when they don't blow their whistle, because coaches are going to get frustrated. And if the whistle's not blown, coaches are going to give the dirty looks. And referees are either going to make the players fair, or they're going to try to make everyone happy. It's a hard role to play as a referee.
This is Buigar now. Back out to Jeremy Lee. Bentley, he's been hot outside tonight. All the way across to Buigar. Thought about pulling it up. And now he's going to bring it down 12 to 11 to shoot. Almost lost it. Now we have a whistle and a timeout called by the bench. John Piercefield saw his guy in trouble and decides to call time.
That was almost a mistake, as I saw Danny almost go for a nice, easy three shot. As he pulls out, everyone that was after him was going for a different person. So it was a beautiful fake maneuver. But when they called that timeout, that prevented Great Lakes from gaining any points there. Danny Brigard made 2 points so far in this game, and let's keep him on fire. Coaches are trying to figure out who all has four fouls and whatnot. And this game has gotten intense. 66-45. This is almost a 20-point game all over again. This is a great, great thing.
Well, they've done much better this half. Great Lakes winning this half. But you've got to find ways to do this in the first half when both sets of starters are on the floor.
Yeah, and that's the thing that cracked me up the most.
8 seconds on the shot clock for your Crusaders.
So they'll put 8 seconds back on the shot clock. Colton, Thomas, Lee, Bentley, and Jalen on the floor. Inbound to Thomas, 7 to shoot. Thomas threw it inside. He wanted Colton down the baseline. And just a miscommunication,
Dana,
and they end
Thomas
up throwing it away.
That's perfectly fine. We have those type of errors every now and then. You know what?
I mean, it's going to happen. There's just going to be some miscommunication. You want to get that stuff cleaned up as quickly as possible. Hobbs coming the other way now. Webb. Columbus underneath, and that's an easy lay.
Columbus has not missed any of his close-up shots.
Colton brings it up over the timeline. This is Bentley now, underneath Lee. Drives, back up to Bentley, pulls up for three. No good off the front rim, rebound all the way out. Last touch by Holy Cross. It will be Great Lakes ball.
Great Lakes has ball.
Dwan Williams will check into the game, replacing Jeremy Lee. Bentley will inbound. Gets it in. They work it around to the top of the key. Now this is Dwan. They'll reset 24. Thomas pulls up for three. No
and a
good
little short. Gets his own
Fights,
rebound.
Tries to get his own rebound, but it's thrown away to O'Brien Hobbs. Hobbs brings it forward. 10 and 22 to go here in the second half. Moore drives, lays it up, gets the roll.
Basket made by number 12.
70 to 45,
Moore.
Coming the other way now, Great Lakes.
Number one,
David Parks
Hop
checks in to the scorer's table. He'll enter the game at the next stop. And that one's going to be knocked away. We have a foul on Clayton Webb.
Foul
got up into the face of Tommy Bentley.
Looked like they were giving each other a high five.
That'll be the fourth on Clayton Webb. Webb has given Great Lakes plenty of trouble underneath tonight, but he's got four fouls, so he'll take a seat. 10 minutes to go here. Parks tries to drive. Doesn't get the roll, but the rebound bounces up to Colton.
Shot missed by number 30, David Parks. Rebound by number 22, Sean Colton.
It fell right in his lap, and he just grabbed it and shot with it.
Well, that's the kind of stuff when that ball falls into your lap under the basket, you really want to get the put pack, and he did.
Yeah.
Columbus puts Colton
shot
on the ground with the juke and
Call
makes the
Columbus
and makes the short jumper. And it's a 25-point game once again. Colton brings it up.
70 to 45.
Back out to Williams. This is Jalen. Tommy Bentley down low. Gives it up. Dwan going to drive. Gets the layup. No, the basket is good. We have a charge, though.
We have a good basket by number three, and after the basket, a foul on number three, DeJuan Williams.
Okay, then. I haven't seen that one in a while. So the basket is good before the charge because he let go of the ball before the charge was committed. 10 minutes to go here. And now the referees are having a conference.
I don't think that's even allowed.
I've never heard of that one.
No. Usually once you play an action, it's
At least not off the top of my head, I haven't heard of that one.
No. It's overly aggressive. It's kind of like doing overly aggressive.
So, okay, how about this? On a made basket for Great Lakes, because Great Lakes are now in the bonus, it appears, Carl Columbus will go to the line to shoot 1-1 for Holy Cross.
Number 24, Carl Columbus steps to the line.
Okay, that's what it looks like. I mean, it wasn't a shooting foul on Great Lakes, obviously. Unless you foul someone while in the you or yourself are in the act of shooting. I don't know. I don't know if that's technically considered a shooting foul.
Correction.
So
number
anyway,
30 will be shooting the free throw.
Dalton Wagler will go to the line for Holy Cross. Either way. And he does make the first end of the 1-1.
Free throw made by number 30.
Okay, then. So I'm not sure exactly how that happened, but
wow.
However,
that's something we're going to
strange things happen in college basketball, my friend.
Second free throw
David
missed.
Parks with the board Rebounded on the second one, which
30,
was missed.
David
Juan
Park.
Williams. William.
Turnover.
Dalton
number
is
three,
one of the more interesting players on this team. He does so many good things for you, but he also commits a lot of turnovers.
Yeah.
He misses a lot of shots. But he's such an active player. He creates so many opportunities. You know what I mean? It's feast or famine
exactly
for him because he's so aggressive. Columbus goes right to the rack. No good. And we're going to get a held ball. Well played. I think that was David Parks. The board comes back down to Dalton Wagler. And Parks gets his hand up and doesn't let him go up.
Jump ball.
Because he
possession.
Didn't make
Holy
with
Cross.
The player, he wins the held ball. Nice play.
Huh.
Possession will stay with Holy Cross. Inbound to Drew Moore. Open look for three. Pumps. Pulls up long. Two. Knocks it
basket
down.
Basket made by number 12.
Little guy.
That was a nice play
Moore.
From Drew Moore. Quick inbound to DeJuan Williams. Across to Jalen. 8:40 to go here in the second. David Parks now. Bentley. Look for three. Knocks
three
it down. 3-point
basket made by Tommy Bentley.
He
assist
is
by number 30. David
tonight.
Park.
He's made them before. I mean, he's shot 31% on the season. Tommy Bentley and David Parks actually with the
Foul
exact same
three,
3-point
DeJuan
shooting
Williams.
Percentage this season.
O'Brien Hobbs will be stepping to the line
at 31%. And now Zoe Bauer will check in.
Number
Holy Cross.
Foul
O'Brien
number three
Hobbs
on DeJuan Williams.
DeJuan Williams is putting down the bench and Sean is going to be on the play.
So the 1-1 coming up for Hobbs.
And everybody's on the line.
First free throw is good. At the next foul, both teams will be
first
in the bonus.
First free throw of the 1-1 is
at
made
the next
by
foul
O'Brien
on
Hobbs.
Holy Cross, rather. That will put Great Lakes in the bonus. The next foul on Great Lakes will put Holy Cross in the double bonus. Second free throw is good from Hobbs. 77-52. James brings it forward. James, Shelton, Colton, Parks, Bentley on the floor for Great Lakes. Bentley at the free throw line. Back out to Parks. Pulls up three high. Post no good. Rebound underneath. Picked up by O'Brien Hobbs. Hobbs brings it the other way. In transition. Throws it away. He wanted Drew Moore in the corner, but he overthrew it.
One, O'Brien Hobbs.
Moore
he was
quite
hurry.
Get to it.
He was in a hurry, and he went in a fast pass, and it was too fast.
Well, there are advantages to playing with pace, and there are disadvantages. The advantage, you can catch your opponent out of position. You can create more opportunities for yourself if you play it cleanly. On the other
basket
end.
Basket made by number 24.
If you
Nathan
don't,
Shelton.
You have more of an
opportunity. Assist.
Sean. More of an opportunity for turnovers, throwing the ball away, mistakes, and you can get punished on the other end. Nathan Shelton gets the layup. For Great Lakes, on the other end, it's Drew Moore with the layup.
Basket made by number 12, Drew Moore.
So a pair of 5'9 guards get layups. Quick transition for Great Lakes. Colton catches on the baseline, tries to throw it back in, but he's out of bounds, and now Sam Anderson will check into the game.
That's a dangerous part about passing this. Such a far end of the game.
Yep. Checking in the game for your Crusaders.
Especially when you have someone
number
else
42,
with you.
Sam Anderson will check into the game, replacing Jalen James. Remember, Anderson has 4 fouls. So this is a test for him to see how far he can go before picking up a fifth. Bauer hops into the corner now to Webb. Back out to Hobbs, 22 to shoot. This is Dalton Wagler. Down low, they're going to keep working it around. They're being patient. Bauer pulls long two, drops it.
Shot made by number 4.
Took a step, gave himself a little bit of separation from Anderson, and then dropped the long two. That was pretty nice. Parks backing down, gives it up to Colton, pulls up top of the key, knocks it down.
3-point basket made by number 22, Sean Colton.
Nice to see him put those away. He's not been the best 3-point shooter on the season, but he shot pretty well tonight. I believe he's 2-for-4 from beyond the arc.
I think it's 3-for-4.
Hobbs, Moore, tries to drive, and he's found separation in there all
shot
night. And now we have a
number 12.
Oh, boy, that didn't look very much. That didn't look like fun. Daryl McIntyre went up. Went up for the ball. He came down pretty hard. Looks like he came down on his lower back. He's up, looks good. Carl Columbus will check in for O'Brien Hobbs, and Daryl McIntyre will stay on the floor. Looked more like an uncomfortable fall than anything else.
It looked like he fell on his arm and hurt his back at the same time. That'd be good for Great Lakes, bad for them.
Colton Bentley. Being closely guarded, throws it to Anderson. Anderson couldn't handle it, and he turned it over.
Turnover by 42, Sam Anderson.
We need to start picking up our heads. We're slowly putting our heads down.
Coming the other way now is Moore running the point. He's created all kinds of problems for Great Lakes tonight. This is McIntyre inside, all the way down to Wagler, who gets the roll on a little hook underneath.
Basket,
now this is Bentley,
30,
Great Lakes down by 28, with coming up on 6 minutes to go. Bentley to Anderson. Anderson back out to Parks. To Colton, 3, top of the key, no good off the front, and that was a good look.
By Sean Colton.
3 rebound, Columbus coming the other way.
Rebounded by number 24.
Back out to Moore. Moore tries to drive. And he'll bring it all the way back. This is Bauer now, inside, and Wagler.
Oh, wow.
Was left wide open in the game.
And
it's an easy lay, and then a 30-point game.
Assist 2.
With 5.5
to
go.
Bauer.
Here in the second, this is Shelton now, who just checked in. Shelton. To Parks in the high post. Underneath the Bentley, and that's swatted away by Moore, and he's going to get whistled.
He knew he was going to happen.
Foul on the red, 12. Tyler Bitley shooting the
Moore
one-on-one.
Go to the bench. Being replaced by
his third.
Danny Weegar will check into the game, replacing Nathan Shelton.
Team 7.
Bentley will shoot the 1-1. Great Lakes down 87-57, 5:26 to go here in second. First free throw gets the roll.
First free throw's good for number 25, Tommy Bentley.
Bentley hasn't had much opportunity from the line. He's on the season. Now he's 5-for-9, of course.
So he's the most accurate shooter.
Free throw gets
free
the roll.
Are good.
Nice to raise your free throw shooting.
Tommy Bentley.
Percentage by 10 points in one trip.
Yeah.
Coming the other way now, Columbus goes rack to rack and lays it in. That was pretty easy, to be honest. Coming the other way now is Colton.
Columbus.
5.25 to go. Lakes down 89-59. Colton gonna walk. Nope, double dribble.
Wow. You know, defensively, Great Lakes has found a way to not be aggressive, but offensively, Great Lakes has found to be very aggressive. Our bastards coming in, but.
So Colton will check out, being replaced by Dana Thomas.
Colton called a play for the team before he left.
First week
working it around. This is Columbus, all the way back out to Bauer.
Defense is good.
Columbus tries to drive, defended well, goes up and over the back, and he couldn't lay it in, but we have a foul. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Foul on number 30.
Looks David like David Parks got him in the head.
Shooting two at the line.
At least that's the call.
Columbus.
And now Columbus will go to the line to shoot two.
And
double bonus.
Great Lakes is on the line. No.
First free throw is good. Columbus, it's 90-59. 4:50 to go here in the second. Second free throw is good.
Second free throw is also
inbound
good
to Bentley,
for 24.
And Dana Thomas Columbus will run the point here. Gives up to Anderson. To Bentley, top of the key. To Buiger now in the high post. Across to Thomas for three, no good front rim. The board picked up by Coley Schultheis. Gives it up to Bauer. Bauer gets past Thomas, kicks it back out to Schultheis underneath to Columbus. Columbus
basket
has been causing all kinds of trouble for Great Lakes underneath.
He knows how to get inside that box without getting in trouble.
Thomas picks up his dribble, gives it to Anderson. Anderson into the corner to Buiger. Back to Bentley, top of the key. Anderson now. Back to Thomas. They'll reset with 17. Parks pulls up three high post. Knocks it down.
3 point good.
His first three
30,
for the night.
David Parks.
Yeah, he's really struggled from outside. Maybe that will get him back. He was shooting pretty well from downtown coming into this one over the last couple of games. Schultheis gives this one into Columbus. Out to Bauer. 20 to shoot. Into the corner, Columbus. Underneath. This is Wagler. Shot no good. Rebound off of McIntyre and
shot
out over the end line.
30, Dalton Wagler. Crusader basketball
Jeremy
on the
Lee
sideline.
Will check into the game.
Great Lakes is our main point.
Okay, there goes Tommy Bentley. On the floor there for a second. Wasn't sure what was going on. Tommy Bentley leaves the floor. I don't think he saw Jeremy Lee coming in to replace him. Thomas to Lee. This is Buiger now. Parks pulls up contested three. No good off the front rim. Just so many contested looks from outside for Great Lakes on the hole tonight. Daryl McIntyre going to drive. My goodness, just took it right to
the rim.
That was a great step by McIntyre. That was a great step by McIntyre.
Beautiful, beautiful play for him.
Thomas, good ball underneath to Lee. Lee backs down. Tough look. No good. Rebound
shot
by McIntyre, 95-62, 3 minutes to
rebound
go here. Great Lakes
20.
Trying to keep Holy Cross under 100. McIntyre over the timeline. Bauer. Working it around now. McIntyre again, tries to drive, gets it to fall. Wow.
Basket made by number 20.
These guys are good. They got their baskets in, they're very formatted.
Sam Anderson will drive, and we have a whistle. No shot.
It's a foul.
They're going to get Zoe Bauer on this.
Sam
Anderson
the
on the line.
What.
One for one.
Daryl McIntyre. Drive. My goodness. Just take it
right to the ball.
First free throw from Anderson is perfect. He's
number
4 for 4 from the line coming into this game.
What was that?
He's 4 for 4 from the line coming into this game.
Wow.
So in limited action from the line, he's done a pretty good job. Second free throw's no good off the front rim, but the rebound, Dana Thomas picks it up. Thomas kicks out Parks, wide open, look for three, no good off the back rim. Strong rebound.
Wow.
Coming the other way, now Aljalon Edwards. Gives it up to McIntyre, who misses on the other end, and that's 5 on Anderson.
Shot missed.
That's going to be 5.
Fifth foul on number 42, Sam
Anderson was out there. I believe he was out there for 5 consecutive minutes.
What's
playing
that?
I believe it was consecutive minutes with only 4, with 4 fouls.
Yeah.
Which is good, but still frustration foul there.
As a young player, again, we're not trained. They're not trained how to use their fouls.
20,
they just want to play. They want to play a ball. They want to play a ball hard. And basketball is not a hard sport. It's more of outsmarting people.
McIntyre's first free throw is no good. Nathan Shelton checked in to replace Anderson. Now Michael Lochner-Pedersen will check in for Daryl McIntyre. As McIntyre makes the second. 98-63, 2-16 to go here in the second. Inbound to Dana Thomas. Thomas brings it forward, gives it up to Jeremy Lee. Lee gives it up to Buigar, back to Shelton. Shelton thought about shooting that, gave it up to Lee. Lee drives, kick out, Buigar. Park, still working it around. This is good basketball from the Lakes, ball underneath. Almost lost, but Shelton picks it up. Shelton now stuck in the corner, 14 to shoot. Trying to get away, able to drive the baseline. Tried to find Lee, but Lee couldn't get to it. Coming the other way is Cully Schultheis. Good play by Shelton. Unfortunate on the pass underneath. This is Ogner-Pedersen. Olajuwon Edwards. Inside, back out to Edwards. Ogner-Pedersen. Cully Schultheis again. Inside, Adam Visor working it around. Ogner-Pedersen shoots, no good. Rebound, Dana Thomas. He's had a few of those tonight. Coming the other way. 1:20 to go. Thomas.
It's all about wasting that time.
Shelton pulls up long three, knocks
it
out.
3-point basket
beautiful
made by number 24, Nathan
three.
Shelton. Assist, Jeremy Lee.
Shelton's been one of the team's better three-point shooters, shooting about 36.7% coming into this one. Schultheis, long three, does not get the roll. Rebound batted out.
3-point basket.
And it will be
by
picked up.
Rebound 32.
By Edwards. With 47 to go underneath, that's stolen by Nathan Shelton.
Steal
coming the other
Nathan
way.
Shelton
going to try to drive, and we have a whistle
with
and
a jump
ball.
Ball.
It will be Great Lakes ball with 39.3 seconds left in the half, down 98-66.
He tried to throw it up so he can get a layup shot, but the opponent had grabbed that ball underneath.
Thomas will inbound from the baseline. All the way in to Jeremy Lee. Gives it up to Thomas. Thomas going to try to drive. Puts up a rough shot. And that one's going to go out over the baseline, being touched out by a defender. So 31 seconds left, or 30.9 seconds left on the game clock. The shot clock is dead. Not sure if Great Lakes will hold for a final shot or if they'll just try to run a play. But either way, this hasn't been the best of outings for Great Lakes.
Not at all. We faced a hard team last week, and we're facing a...
That one's stolen away. Coming the other way is Olajuwon Edwards. Holy Cross trying to find their 100th, and they do, and one.
And one.
Are they going to make it 101? Dalmatians?
3 foul number 30,
fouls.
David Parks is fourth.
Four fouls for David Parks.
Edwards on the line, trying to finish the three-point play. He does not. The board is picked up by Parks. 20 seconds left in this one. Coming the other way, this is Thomas. Underneath to Buigar, pulls up mid-range jumper, doesn't get the roll. Rebound, bounds off the backboard. 10 seconds to go. Cully Schultheis will bring it across, gives it up to Michael Ogner-Pedersen, who gives it to the official. This
Realistically, you're not supposed
final
to give the official the ball
game
until after the buzzer goes off. Great Lakes could have stolen that ball and made a big bunch of
money.
It didn't matter.
Join them on
there
Wednesday as your Great Lakes Christian
time,
College
will,
Crusaders host
Holy Cross 100, Great Lakes 66. All right. What can Great Lakes take away from this? What are the positives from tonight?
You know, the Great Lakes, we've done a phenomenal job. We always come back our second half. Second half is always our strongest half. Our shooting is accurate more in the second half than it's always usually is in the first half. I don't understand how that works out, but usually is it that because of the discipline of the coach, or is that because of the passion of wanting to get back out of the hole and get do something with that purpose? But Great Lakes has to find a way to keep up the positive in the first half. If we can be very strong, go out strong in the first half. That was our biggest problem. We couldn't keep up with the points in the first half.
All right, well, that will do it for us. Great Lakes have some work to do before they host IU East on Wednesday. That game will be at 7 o'clock. Be sure to join us You can catch that game live on YouTube. Or, of course, you could just come here to the Doty Center, too. I mean, that's always a good idea.
Yeah.
But, yeah, Great Lakes taking on IU East on Wednesday. Be sure to join us for that. Until next time, thank you for listening. I'm Colton Wesley.
I'm Julio Wilbanks.
Don't forget to follow us on Twitter at GLCC Sports. Check us out online, glcc.edu/athletics. Join us on Wednesday, 7 o'clock, Great Lakes hosting IU East. Until then, final score here, Great Lakes Christian College 66, Holy Cross 100. Thank you for joining us. This is the Great Lakes Christian College Television Network.